Maybe that depends more on the guys on site than on me. Welcome to wonderful Ötztal in Austria for the Velosolutions UCI Pump Track World Championships. This is not the place where you'd usually take your bike at this time of the year, but we are at the AREA47 for the first ever indoor Pump Track World Championships. So there's actually no reason for being up here, except for a lot of the riders have never seen snow before.
What did I sign up for?
Enough. We are at the brand new Velosolutions pump track at the AREA47 in Austria, together with Ryan from Australia and Brady from the USA. They're gonna show us the details of this track, which is a lot shorter than any of the other World Championships tracks that we've had before. It's about half the length, which means the riders will have to push it a lot harder and be a lot more precise with anything they do during the race. Let's have a look. This track is so compact that we're basically going from turn into turn straight away. There's not much of a straight in between the turns. Still though, the riders will find some different ways on how to push or jump these rollers. Even though the track is very compact, the speeds are still high and the G-forces in these turns are absolutely crazy. We measured above 10 G. As you can see, the stage is ready, the spotlights are on, and we are expecting lap times of as little as 11 seconds, which is extremely short, and that does not make it any easier for the riders at all, because they will have to be incredibly precise on this track and push their limits to where there is no more limits. All right, there we are. This is the Velosolutions Pump Track World Championships, as you know, otherwise you wouldn't be here. We're ready for the round of eight already. We've gone through two rounds, very exciting, a lot of surprises. This track is very short, as I already said it earlier, but it is challenging and brought its victims. Victims in the sense of two world champions already dropping out, two former world champions, Tommy Zula and Nils Bensink, already not in the game anymore. We'll come to that later. What is there to say? Well, quite a lot. I don't even know what to start. We had so much action already, and we're diving into this later. Currently, well, there we go. This is Tommy Zula on his last try to make it into the top eight in the last round. He did not make it. He tried several times, wasting his energy. Actually, not wasting, he had to go as hard as he could. It was just not enough. Ending up in ninth place, which was not enough, because this is now the round of eight. Same happened to Nils Bensink, probably playing it a bit too cool in the early rounds, not pushing it hard enough, meant he had to do another lap, and with, you know, spending that energy on his first lap, he just didn't have enough in the tank to go again. There we go. This is our rankings from the round of 16 with the big surprise. Well, not for me, because I knew he was fast. Ryan Gilchrist from Australia, the mountain biker and the only mountain bike left in the game for today. Actually, in the lead. He won the round of 16. So all the rest of the eight riders is on BMX. In the women's field, we have, not a surprise, there is Christopher Niederhäusern completely dominating the field so far. Won both rounds so far, the world champion of 2022 from Switzerland. She's actually double world champion already, so she's gonna try to make it a triple today. And I think now I am throwing it to Max, who is ready for us on the track. Let's hope that works. I know I'm beautiful, but I don't need to be on screen right now. And I don't know what to tell you either, because we're waiting for Max. He's even more beautiful than me. So, while Max is standing out there in the dark, we just show you some more shots from the round of 16. This is actually the Swiss rider Tristan Borel, currently sitting in second. The riders are not actually catching much air time. They could, but they know they would lose time if they do. So they're all staying on the ground, pumping as hard as they can for those 12 seconds. So there we go. We are on track. We're waiting for the spotlights to go bright on Max. We don't see him there. Well, at least it looks cool. We are at the Area 47 here at the bottom of the Ötztal. Area 47 that has a lot more to offer than just this pump track. There's lots of activities. The area has been loved by action sportsmen from all over the world coming here to get their kick. The indoor bike park was added to it only last year. And we're quite happy to hold the world championships here. And there I see a spotlight. Maybe we'll have Max in sight. There he is. Max is usually not hesitating when he has to talk. Today he seems to be, but don't worry, he's going to talk enough later on. Riders are warming up. They are nervous. Their pressure is on. This title means a lot to them. And as you can see, how nervous they are, as two of the former world champions are already out. Eddy Clerte, one of the other world champions, the world champion from 2021 from Lisbon. The French rider Eddy Clerte.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. It's time to go racing at the 2023 Velosolutions UCI Pump Track World Championships here at Area 47 in Ötztal in Austria. Let's get ready to introduce our top eight women to you. Coming up first, let's give a big round of applause from Belgium. It's Julie Huysjoquin.
All right, so we're going into the rider's introduction. Women first.
Qualifying in eighth place is Julie Huysjoquin. She's been incredible this year, coming back, a big BMX background, and now on to the pump track. In seventh place from Sweden, it's Felicia K. Klinstrom. As she gets ready to go out and just roll the course one last time. In six from the United States of America, it's Carly Kane. In five from Belgium, your 2021 world champion in Lisbon, Portugal, Aiko Gomez. In four from Latvia, she was third at the World Championships in Santiago, Chile, South America last year. It's Vanita Pettersson. In three from the Czech Republic, second at the World Championships in 2022, Sabina Korsakova. A newcomer in number two from Germany. Welcome, Alina Beck. And in the number one spot, your two times world champion from Switzerland, it's Christa von Niederhausen. There we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Your top eight women are ready to go racing here at Area 47 in Uttal in Austria.
All right, so we're lining up for the quarterfinals. Eight riders in the game. So it starts with one rider on track at a time. Each rider gets a lap, and then we start the open session. The open session meaning the riders have 5 minutes to do as many laps as they want if they want to do a rerun. If they're feeling safe that they're going to advance into the next round, they don't need to do a rerun. They can just sit back and wait. But if they are on the bubble, meaning somewhere around the fourth place, they will have to do another one. So on track, we have Julie Huiskin from Belgium, who placed eighth in the last round, meaning she was the slowest rider from the last round. She just made it into this round. She's opening up this round with a 14.6. Next rider up is the Swedish rider, winner from the qualifier in Sweden, Felicia Klingström. She actually just made it into this round in the very, very last minute from the last session. She was not going to be in it, but then improved her lap time. And she did it again here, sitting in first, almost half a second faster, actually half a second faster than Julie Huiskin from Belgium. On course now, Carly Kane from the USA. She had no problem getting into this round of eight. She wasn't really on the bubble. And clearly faster again. Well, clearly meaning less than 2/10 of a second. Actually just 16/100 of a second faster. And there you see how close these times are gonna go. Aiko Gomez, the world champion from 21 in Portugal, now on track. One of the remaining world champions in the race. What can she do? Going into first place. 1/10 of a second faster than Carly Kane from the USA. And as you know, as you see, it's a flying start. Riders get half a lap to speed up before they cross the start line. Vinetta Pettersson already did that. She is on course. Second place. She did a lot more laps than she would have had to in the previous rounds. She was quite safe to advance into the next round, but decided to do another lap anyway, which is hard to understand because most riders would choose to hold back, do as little laps as possible to save their energy for the upcoming round. Sabina Korsakova going into second. Korsakova from Czech Republic Less than a tenth of a second behind Aiko Gomez. Now on track, the surprise from Germany, Alina Back. She was in second place in the last round. Will she go into first? Maybe a little mistake there in the turn. Lost a bit of time, but it is enough for first place. 600th of a second faster than former world champion Aiko Gomez. But now we have Swiss world champion Christa von Niederhausen on track, who has been dominating the race so far. She never had to do a rerun because she was so fast in every single lap she did. What is it gonna be now? Again, first, but not by much, only by 600th of a second. 600th of a second faster than Alina Back. Now, all of these riders have done one lap, which means the open session starts. We have 4 minutes to go. Well, to be more exact, 3 minutes 40 now. 3 minutes 35 to go for those riders to give it another go. And you see rider Vinetta Peterson and Carly Kane, they will have to go pretty soon to try to improve their time to make it into the top four. As you know, only four riders are gonna advance into the next round. We have Carly Kane from the USA on track. Is she gonna be able to improve her time? No, she is not. She is not. Her fastest time is still 13.9. And it might be a smarter idea for the riders to wait a little, recover a bit more, and only go for another lap just before this open session ends. And this is probably what the riders are doing right now, waiting to see who is going, recovering. They have 2 minutes 40 left to improve their times. We have Vinetta Peterson from Latvia, Carly Kane from the USA, Felicia Klingström from Sweden, and Julie Huiska from Belgium, who need to improve their times if they want to advance into the semifinals. It is a tough game, both on your body and your mind, because you really don't know how soon you should give it another go. When your body is ready to improve your time, your lap time, and when it is not. So, we have Julie Huiska from Belgium. Giving it another try. She's on course. Yeah, there was a little mistake in the second turn already, and she felt it. So she immediately gave up, knowing that she will not improve her time. And if she wants to give it another try, it's better to just let go, try to recover. She still has 90 seconds left. And there we have Vinetta Peterson, currently sitting in fifth. It doesn't take much. She has to improve her time by only 200th of a second to make it in the round of the four, but she did not improve her time. She actually was slower, so still sitting in fifth. Now Sabina Kozarkova, she is actually in fourth, but wants to play it safe, so she's gonna go for another one, trying to improve the time. She did not. Still sitting in fourth with her 13.9. Felicia Klingström from Sweden giving it another try. We have 30 seconds left in this round. Looks like not much is moving. Is Felicia Klingström improving her time? She is not. And we have Carly Kane from the USA giving it another go. Can she make it? This is probably, certainly, her last try. She did not improve her time. She is staying in sixth place. And Julie Huiska from Belgium giving it another go. She's the very last rider on track in this round. But she looks tired there. This is not gonna improve her time. So, We have the semi-final set with Christopher Niederhäusern in first, Alina Beck from Germany in second, Aiko Gommers from Belgium in third, and Sabina Kozarkova from Czech Republic in fourth. These are your riders for the semi-finals. Meaning two former world champions still in the game, Christopher Niederhäusern from Switzerland, Aiko Gommers from Belgium. Giving it a little break here before we go in the round, into the round of eight of the men. Here you see the results from the quarterfinals of the women. Still very surprising, the newcomer Alina Beck, winner of the German qualifier, putting a lot of pressure here on Krista. Krista has been untouchable so far, but untouchable on this kind of track means a difference of only 600th of a second. Imagine how little that is. We have been calculating with the average speed on track, what 1/100th of a second actually means. And 1/100th of a second on this track means 10 centimeters. So a lot of the decisions today will be taken in less than 10 centimeters. Maybe we have some graphics for that. There we go. There is the graphic. You see 104 millimeters equals to 1/100th of a second. That means in 1/10th of a second, riders go more than 1 meter. And in 1 second, riders will actually go 10 meters far. With a track length of 130 meters, that's where you see where we're at with 13 seconds time. It's gonna go a little faster with the men's field. And so men are preparing, men are getting nervous. We're ready to introduce them to you. As I said earlier in the show, lots of surprises in the round of 16 with some of the favorite riders. Some of the riders with the most experience in this whole game already dropping out. We've got some replays here from the round of eight, from the women, pushing it hard. World champion from Switzerland. No, that was actually Aiko Gommers. It was already very tight, and it will be a lot tighter. We're gonna see if we're gonna have some ties. We already in the earlier round, we did have some ties, meaning equal times down to the milliseconds. And we do have the rules ready. If we do have ties down to the milliseconds, we're actually gonna count the results from the previous round. But if we do have a tie in the men's final, or not just in the men's final, in any final at the very end, we're gonna go for a rerun. So it is not only about the technique of the riders, it's also about their fitness and how they can recover. In between runs. There we have Tommy Zula still from the round of eight. No, actually, that's still from the round of 16. I'm sorry. Because he didn't even make it into the round of 8. Round of 8 is still coming up here for the men. We are waiting for them to get ready, get on stage. It's getting silent out there in the hall at the indoor bike park at the Area 47. It's getting silent. That means we're getting ready to introduce those riders. Here again, we see the results from the round of 16 with Ryan Gilchrist from Australia, the only mountain biker left in the game. But he's in the lead. All the rest behind him that are still in the race are on BMX bikes. Will it stay like that? That is the big discussion in the field. Are mountain bikes competitive on a pump track against BMX? Well, Ryan Gilchrist definitely thinks so. I'm wondering if one of the riders didn't pump up his tires and we're still waiting for him to get his bike ready there, or what's the hold up there? One still sitting in massage. If Tommy Zula was still in the race, I would have said he's got his hair not nicely done yet and we need to wait for that, but he's not, so it can't be that.
Through to one.
All right, there we go. Introduction.
Qualifying in eighth place. From France, please help me welcome Anaya Estil. Qualifying in seventh from Switzerland, it's Tanji Grandjean. In sixth place for Italy, it's Matteo Costermann. In fifth place for France, welcome Eddie Clerte. In fourth place for the United States of America, second last year at the World Championships, it's Alec Bob. Into the top three now, third fastest from France, Thibaut Dupont. In number two for Switzerland, their national champion, Tristan Borel. And then, ladies and gentlemen, your fastest qualifier out of the last round, representing Australia, it's Ryan Gilchrist. So there it is, ladies and gentlemen, the rider introductions are done. It's down to business now.
As each some of the faces very tense already. The pressure is on. This title means a lot for them. And you see one only guy with bigger wheels there. All the rest are on small wheels, meaning 20 inch, meaning BMX. And we're starting with the slowest rider out of the round of 16, which is number six, Anaya Estil. He was eighth in the last round. And last rider on course we're gonna see is Ryan Gilchrist, the winner of the last round. So let's see what time Anaya Estil can pump down here. Oh, that was a little mistake, a little offline there, meaning he will probably have to give it another go. What is it? 13.3, not a very fast time. Actually a very slow time, and he knows it. This will have to be a rerun for him in the open session. You can see up there, the open session will be 4 minutes long. Currently on track, Tanguy Grandjean from Switzerland. Also very much offline. Oh, wow, what is going on here? Riders are getting nervous. It is the World Championships. Next rider on track. Flying star, Mattia Kosterman, the surprise from Italy. Can he take the pressure? He won the seeding round yesterday, but maybe that played with his head. Can he take that pressure? What is it? First at the moment, first with a 12.61, but next one up is former world champion, Eddie Clerte, number 5, you can see him. Eddie Clerte from France, probably the one that takes this sport the most serious. Can he do it again? He definitely wants those rainbow stripes back. The guy that takes the biggest risks here, so riding some of the turns above the red line. In second place, meaning Mattia Kosterman from Italy staying in the lead. But next up, Alec Bob from the USA, another guy who takes this very serious. Second from last year. Can he take the lead here? Again, the same as most of them, staying on the ground. Now, oh, he is jumping. What is it? Third place. And third place means only 300th of a second behind first place. So, wow, look at how close those times are. Currently on the track, Thibaut Dupont, the French champion, the French national champion. Staying low. But, oh, fourth. This is tight. This might not be enough, almost certainly not enough, because we still have more riders to come here. On track, Tristan Borel from Switzerland, second fastest from the last round. Riding the turns very high. Woo, that last turn. Oh, going into the lead, Tristan Borel, with only one rider left. The one with the big wheels, Ryan Gilchrist from Australia. Ready, there we go. Can he top that time from Tristan Borel? Look at how fast that time was. Actually, almost 2/10 faster than anyone else, and 2/10 is a lot. Can Ryan top that? Oh, I see a little mistake. He lost a bit of speed. Oh, another little mistake. Oh, no! Two mistakes is not gonna make it. Only in sixth place means he has to go again. He's now got 4 minutes. 4 minutes in the open session. You see the clock started ticking up there. The riders will have to recover from that first lap they did, and within those 4 minutes, they can try to improve their time. And Ryan Gilchrist is certainly gonna try that. He was in the lead before. He's not gonna let that go so easily, but the problem is you need to recover within those 4 minutes to perform again, to give it all. And you might think it's only a 12 seconds sprint, but these 12 seconds take everything out of your body. And if you want to give it all again, it does take quite some fitness to recover that quick. Tristan Borel from Switzerland in the lead. Mattia Kosterman, the surprise from Italy, in second. Eddie Clerte, the former world champion, in third. And Eddie Clerte, we know that he is playing it smart. We know also how he got his world champion's title. was by playing it smart, by not going all in right from the start, right in the early rounds, so that he could ramp it up towards the later rounds, towards when it really counted. Is he gonna play that same game today? He's definitely the one with the most experience in the game. So there we have Anaya Istil from France lining up again. We have 2 minutes to go in this round. Taking some more deep breaths here. Going through the course in his head. 1 minute 50 to go, and we know we're gonna see Ryan Gilchrist lining up again and Thibaut Dupont lining up again. They both want to make it into those top four, meaning the semi-final. All right. Anaya on track. Flying start, going fast over the start line. Really fast into, oh! He already made a mistake and knows it. He knows it, he lost it there. Maybe he's gonna try to line up again within that next minute. There's still a minute left. Next up on track. Tanguy Grandjean from Switzerland. Tanguy Grandjean currently sitting in eighth. Oh, can he improve that much? It's a tall order, going from eighth place into fourth. Ah, he improved, but not enough. He's in sixth place. It's not enough to advance. There is Ryan Gilchrist on track. Is it gonna be? Can he do it? Can, is his nerves, is he too nervous or is he not? Can he do it? Come on. Again, another mistake right there into fifth. Fifth is not enough. He's out. He's out. There's not enough time. Oh, wow. It is over. We've got one more rider, but also with a mistake there. Thibaut Dupont cannot improve his time. That means actually, we have Mattia Kosterman still on course. Not needed, though. He's sitting in second. There's no reason for him to do another lap. Not sure why he is wasting his energy there doing another lap. But it doesn't matter. We've got the semifinals lined up. Another surprise. Ryan Gilchrist, who was basically dominating so far. He is out. We have four riders left. Tristan Borel from Switzerland, Mattia Kosterman from Italy, Eddie Clerte from France, and Alec Bob from the USA. Now these riders are gonna go back to the home trainer, spin out their legs, try to recover as much as they can before we go into the semifinals. Here you have the whole result again from the quarterfinals. Ryan Gilchrist in fifth. Too nervous, he had it there, but he was too nervous making those mistakes in both of his tries. Thibaut Dupont, same thing. Tanguy Grandjean, Anaya is still also eliminated. Four different nations in the round of four in the semi-final, which is coming up shortly. So there we go with the start list of the semi-finals of the women. Christa von Niederhäusern from Switzerland, former world champion, actually double world champion already. Eiko Gommers from Belgium, also former world champion. Sabina Kozarkova from Czech Republic. and Alina Beck from Germany. Those are the four that are going to be showing up for the semifinals. As said, this is not only about physical strength, this is much more so about mental strength. You have to be so precise. We have a couple of replays from the quarterfinal here from the men.
So 2 minutes, ladies and gentlemen, 2 minutes until we get into the next round for the elite women. It's into what is known as the semi-finals. The top four women will come through. They'll each get one round and then they'll go into their...
As you can see, we've built this pump track as a pump park, meaning it has no green spaces in between. Means when there's not too many people on track, the riders can actually choose their lines wherever they want to go and freestyle it up. Use it less like a track and more like a park, like a skate park, and, you know, jump from one bowl to the other. Yesterday we had a little freestyle session with the riders, and some of the riders have pulled quite some gnarly tricks there. You will see them on our Instagram feed. The riders do love their time on the track. I almost had to stop them from riding yesterday, tell them, save your energy for the race. It's the World Championships. I know you love riding, but maybe you want to save it a little bit for the race. At some point, we had to turn off the lights in here because they just wouldn't stop riding. So this is actually where we had qualifiers throughout the year. In all of these different countries, we had qualifiers, and each winner of a qualifying event won a ticket to come here to Austria for the final at the end of the season. And actually, the top four riders of each qualifier was allowed to come here, but only the winner of each qualifier won a ticket. So we are introducing the riders of the semifinals.
It's Christa von Niederhausen.
Christa von Niederhausen from Switzerland. And as you see, the first rider that you're going to see on track is number three, Sabina Kozarkova from Czech Republic. Again, we are going one lap for each one, and then we start the open session, which is where they can improve their time, or at least try to improve their time. Flying start, we get half a lap to speed up. Now crossing the start line, and there we go. Sabina Kozarkova on track. Setting the time at 13.73. Next up is Aiko Gomez from Belgium. The only pedal strokes they do is to get out of that start box. As soon as they're on track, pedaling doesn't mean anything anymore because you'll be pumping as hard as you can. Aiko Gomez doing exactly that. Is it going to be enough? She needs to go into the top two of this round. And this is not looking good. She's only second at the moment with German rider Alina Beck coming up. Alina Beck, this surprise from Germany, Can she hold it together? We know she's fit, but is she also mentally strong to hold the pressure? Not sure if she's got the speed here. Let's see. Ooh, not looking good at all. Third only. And there we have double world champion Christa von Niederhäusen ready to go. Can she keep it together? The most experienced rider out of all of them. She's been at every single world championships there were so far, starting. Oh, there was a little mistake there, but just a little one. Is it gonna be enough? Yes, it is. Keeps it steady, keeps it constant. First place in every single round so far. 1/900th of a second faster than Sabina Kozarkova. With Aiko Gomez and Alina Beck definitely having to go and attack again. As you can see, the clock is ticking up top. We have 3.5 minutes still for the riders to try to go again. Aiko Gomez will have to improve her time by 1/1500th of a second only. So by going 1/15 or 1/16 of a second faster, she will advance into the next round. Here we see Christa von Niederhäusen's run again. It wasn't perfect. There was a little mistake in a turn, but it was good enough to hold on to that lead. Oh, you see, there was a lot of risk involved. Look how high up she is riding those turns. She was actually entering two of the turns at the red line, even above that red line. We know how risky that is. There were quite some accidents last year when riders were riding above the red line, taking that risk. So far it went well for Christa this year. And here we have a replay of the run of Alina Beck. Not the best run of hers this today. We know she can do a lot better than that. So she will be lining up. She's currently recovering from that first run. She's got 2 minutes to go. Knowing that there's only gonna be one more chance, she's probably gonna wait for the very last moment before she gets on track again. They have to cross the start line before the 4 minutes are over. 1:30 to go. Okay, there she's getting ready. She knows she can do it. And if she does it, the other riders, especially Sabina, will have to line up and get to the start straight again. Sabina Kozarkova waiting there in the back, because if her time gets beaten, she will have to line up and go to the start straight away. Alina Beck, this is looking, I was gonna say it's looking better, but I'm not so sure. There was a mistake, a big one actually, and she lost quite a lot of speed right there. It's not gonna be enough. It's not enough, she's out. Meaning, Kozarkova might not have to go again. There is Aiko Gomez coming again. Aiko Gomez, we know what she can do. She is a former world champion, but she has to have a perfect run now if she wants to go into the top two. Yes, keeping it very low. Yes, this is looking good, actually. What is it gonna be? Not enough. Not enough. So Sabina Kozarkova had to go, but she did. She's not gonna finish. She is in the final. We have Two riders in the final, Christopher Niederhäusern from Switzerland and Sabina Kozarkova. Surprise. These are the two riders that are gonna fight it out for the World Championships title. The other two, Aiko Gomez and Alina Beck, are gonna go again as well for the bronze medal. So, another little surprise with another world champion dropping out. Aiko Gomez, world champion from Lisbon in 21. Eliminated in the semifinal. Christopher Niederhäusern continues her domination. Again, when I say domination, it is less than 2/10 of a second. It's 1/900 of a lead that she has. And that means just one tiny little mistake and you could lose that lead. But she has been very, very consistent so far. There was almost no mistakes by Christopher Niederhäusern. Again, here you can see what 0.01 seconds actually means. It's 104 millimeters, so 10 centimeters in between those riders, and sometimes even less. Now the wheel size there is actually a 26 inch, which we don't have any of them in the race anymore. We only have 20 inch wheels in the race by now, as Ryan Gilchrist from Australia got eliminated. We have the men's semifinals coming up. Number one, you can see Italy's Mattia Kosterman. Number four, you can see Tristan Borel, the Swiss champion. And next to them, Francis Eddie Clerte. You can see him on the right there, focusing with the music on his head. Can he ramp it up and catch those two guys in front of him? He wasn't as dominant this week as he was in the past. Ready for them to get on stage. The other rider that we haven't seen there was Alec Bob from the USA. He is the fourth rider in this semifinal. There we go. Alec Bob, Eddie Clerte, Tristan Borel, Mattia Kosterman are the remaining four riders in the game here. This is him. He's right, wearing a big jacket here. It's pretty cold, even though we're inside. Luckily, we're not outside. It's even colder outside. Eddie Clerte from France, former world champion. Not cracking a smile there. Taking it serious. This is the World Championships, right? From Italy, Mattia Kosterman. And from Switzerland, Tristan Borel. Again, we're gonna start with the slowest guy from the round, from the quarterfinal. The slowest, who was Alec Bob. So Alec Bob decides not to wear his jacket for his run. And there we go, into the semifinals. He has been focused all week long, very focused. Speeding up, first half lap before crossing the start line, which is now the case. On track, Alec Bob in the semi-final World Championships 2023 here at the Area 47. Okay, a very fast time, number one. Well, obviously number one. He's the only one who's did a lap. It is a very fast time, though. Next up, Eddie Clerte. The track is clear for him. Can he hold it together? Starting slow here, but now speeding up. Time counts now. We know he's entering those turns extremely high, taking a lot of risk. Oh, this is looking good. This is looking very good. Very strong ride from here. They're second place only, though. Only second place with 0.09 of a second behind Alec Bob. That is a surprise. That is a surprise, and it could mean that we're eliminating the last remaining world champion. But now on track, Mattia Kostermann. Can he hold up to that pressure? Can he? Ooh, that turn did not look as fast, but what is it gonna be? Second, meaning Eddie Clerte is currently out. Doesn't mean anything, he can counteract, but look at the time between Alec Bob and Mattia Kostermann. There is actually only 0.01 of a second in between the two. Tristan Borel on track. Oh no, there was a mistake. He felt it straight away, giving up straight away, making sure he's not wasting his energy. So now, this is where the 4 minutes are going to start. The 4 minute open session where the riders can improve their times. And this certainly means Eddie Clerte and Tristan Borel are going to go again. We know that Tristan Borel has it in him. He can win this race, but it is a mental game, even more so now that he messed up his first lap. He has to recover quick now. He was smart enough to immediately stop pushing, not wasting his energy, knowing he's got to go again. But it does play with your head. You know, you most probably only have one more chance. And this has to be the one. And if either one, Eddie or Tristan, is going to go into the top two, it means that Mattia Kostermann will have to go again to try to make it back in there. So Alec Bob warming up again in his jacket there. The track is empty, waiting for those riders to come again. We have 2 minutes, 45 seconds in this open session. Who goes first? Both Eddie and Tristan are very experienced. They both know if they want to improve their times, they have to recover as long as they possibly can. They cannot go too early because their body has not recovered yet from the first lap they did. And if they play it to the very last second, it will have to be that one and only run where they improve their time. Eddie Clerte will have to go only 0.08 of a second faster to beat Mattia Kostermann's time and therefore be in the top two. We've got 1 minute, 45 seconds to go. Eddie Clerte is not waiting. Eddie Clerte is already lining up. We know he can do it, but we also know there's absolutely no mistake allowed. You can see the rainbow stripes there on his wrist. Once you got those rainbow stripes, you'll have them all lifelong. But Eddie does not want to just have them on his wrist. He wants to have them on his chest. And only the current world champion can wear them on his chest. That's what Eddie is here for. Get them back. Tristan Borel also lining up to come again. And there he goes, Eddie Clerté. Picking up speed, now accelerating. Start line crossed, no mistakes allowed. All in for Eddie Clerté. Oh, have you seen how high up he's riding those turns? That is crazy. Is it gonna be enough? No, it is not. Eddie Clerté is out. What a surprise. Eddie Clerté will not get those rainbow strikes back. We only have 8 seconds left to go in the semifinals. It means Tristan Borel has crossed the start line just in time. This has to be it. This has to be the perfect lap for him. And if it is not, he's not gonna be in the run. What is it? What is it? Fourth. Oh no, he's out as well. Out meaning still in the race for bronze, but out in the race for gold. What a surprise. Alec Bob taking the lead in the semifinal. Mattia Kostermann from Italy in second. And look at the time difference in between the two. We are talking about 1/100th of a second. Now you know how tight this final is gonna be. The final will not have an open session anymore. It will be just one single run. One single round that counts. No more fooling around. It will be just that one round. But we are gonna start though with the small finals. The small finals of the women, and small finals meaning the round for bronze medal. While we see some slow-mos of the semifinals, this is the big surprise from Italy, Mattia Kostermann. Well, some would say it's not a surprise because they have seen him riding at the Italian qualifier already. They told me, watch out for this guy. Watch out for this guy. This guy might take the rainbow stripes. And it is looking pretty good for him, isn't it? Yeah, the indoor bike park making it pretty special for us here. There's not that many places in the world where we could go at this time of the year without being in super cold weather, unless we would go to the southern hemisphere, which was actually the plan at first. We were supposed to go to Argentina, but then last minute we had to change venues. We were lucky enough to have the Area 47 here at the Ötztal in Austria to be ready for the big finals. And it is quite special to be indoors for a mountain biking event. Here you can see the results again for the semifinals. We have no more former world champion in the game. Eddie Clerté is only gonna go for bronze. In the middle there, you can see Christopher Niederhäusern, world champion 2018, as well as 2022. We are going to go into the small final with Aiko Gomez from Belgium against Alina Beck from Germany. Giving them a couple of more moments to recover from their last round. Not much longer though. They will have to line up. Aiko Gomez, not only very fast, but also extremely skilled. Yesterday, she almost won the manual contest against the men. Manual meaning, how far can you ride on this track on just a rear wheel? And Aiko Gomez basically almost took the win against the men. There she is, Aiko Gomez, number four. Definitely wanted to go for the rainbow stripes again. Now she'll have to fight it for the bronze medal against German rider Alina Beck. It is a different game. Alina Beck probably going to be very happy with the bronze medal, while I'm not so sure if Aiko Gomez is going to be happy with the bronze medal. But there's no more in it for her. Sports director giving her the good to go. Small final of the Velosolutions UCI Pump Track World Championships here at the Area 47 in Austria. We are ready. Let her go. And there she is on track, speeding up. A couple of rollers, one turn, and then crossing the start line. Time is ticking. This is the race for the small, not for the small final, actually for the bronze medal. Alina Beck on track. And as said, we're not going to have an open session. It's just this one single run that counts. Aiko Gomez speeding up in the small final. This is the race for the bronze medal. It's looking good. Does she still have enough in the tank? It is. It has been a lot of runs throughout the week, a lot of training runs. Pushing it. What is it gonna be? Second! Meaning Alina Beck is taking bronze. What a surprise. Congratulations, Alina. 1500th in between the two. Alina Beck, 1500th faster than Aiko Gomez. Bronze medal goes to Germany. There you go. As you can see, almost nothing in between the two. 1500th. Aiko Gomez not taking any medal back from these world championships. Alina Beck is taking medal back, the bronze medal. And now we are ready for the men's small final. Same as with the women, with one former world champion in the game, Frances Eddie Clerté, and Swiss national champion Tristan Borel. Tristan Borel, no matter what, he's also going to show up pretty good at the party later on. As you can see, he already dyed his hair for it. But for now, let's focus on who will take the bronze medal. Switzerland against France. With Tristan probably starting first, since he was the slower one out of the last heat, out of the semi-final. So Tristan will have to go first, and then Eddie can react to his time. And if Tristan messes it up, Eddie knows that he can just play it safe and have a clean run. But if Tristan puts on a good time, he puts on the pressure on Eddie. We know that Eddie can handle pressure, but still, he would prefer if he was in the big final and not the small final. So let's see. How much these two can still get excited about the bronze medal. They both wanted to go for more than that. Speeding up, small final, Switzerland is on track. Tristan Borel crossing the start line. Looking good, very, very clean there. Just on the red line, just on the red line. Oh, not a bad time, 12.66. It's definitely doable for Eddie Clerté. He knows that, but it's not an easy one. There's no holding back. Looking like there's a little problem on his front wheel. Maybe his tire is not correctly on the rim. He's probably asking for a... Yeah, mechanic needs to come. They need to reset his front tire. As I explained earlier in the game, in the show, there is quite a crazy pressure on these riders, on these tires, in these turns. The G-forces are going through the roof. The riders have to pump their tires harder than what they're actually made for, just so that the tires don't fold under that pressure in those turns. There you see Eddie's father acting as his mechanic. And you really do not want your tire to pop off the rim when you go through a turn at this speed. So maybe not quite sure what's going on there. Just putting that tire into the correct position and then pumping it up again. They are going up to 6 bars. It's pretty crazy how much pressure they put in there, but they have to, because otherwise those tires will just fold and it gets really, really dangerous. And Eddie Clerté knows exactly what it means. Crashing in a turn at the World Championships. He did that last year and went straight to hospital. All right. That was a quick pit stop. There we go again. Can Eddie beat that time? of Tristan Borel. This whole situation gave the other people from the big final a bit more time to recover, which they probably appreciate. Eddie just double checking that the tire is not going to pop off the rim again. He's not quite sure of it. That's a scary one. Okay, there we go. Accelerating. Crossing the start line now. We are on track with Eddie Klett's final lap of this year's World Championships. In the small final, can he take the bronze medal? Oh, taking so much risk again. Have you seen how high up he was? Oh, this is fast. Yes. Yes, he did beat the time of Tristan. That is bronze medal for Eddie Klett. Congratulations. Wow, he did take that pressure. He did take a lot of risk too, though. Riding above the red line again. This is taking so much risk. Congratulations. Bronze medal to Eddie Klerte. We know he's gonna come back for more next year again. And you can see only 700th of a second in between these two. All right, he made it spectacular with that little pit stop. Now we are ready for the big finals though. For when it really counts. It's not only a gold medal, it is the bag, what we call it. The bag meaning the jersey, the white jersey with the rainbow stripes on it. That's what the riders are going for. There was quite a lot of pressure on Eddie Klerte after that crash he had last year, after that really bad crash, sending him to hospital straight away. I would say that's a pretty strong comeback from him. We are now going into the women's big final though, which is Sabina Kozarkova from Czech Republic against Krista von Niederhäusern from Switzerland. You see the two. Who can handle the pressure better? We know it's only about dealing with pressure. It's only about your mental strength.
In Austria.
This is it. This is the final lap of the Velosolutions UCI Pump Track World Championships 2023. This is where it really counts. This is where you get the rainbow stripes. One of these two ladies are going to get them. Sabina Kozarkova or Krista von Niederhäusern.
Krista von Niederhäusern!
There she comes.
Here it is, ladies and gentlemen, what we've all been waiting for. This is exactly what it looked like last year.
No more open session, one and only run. This run needs to be perfect. Just like any run before, because the times are so tight. No one could actually play any strategical games.
And she is going to go first. So she's
Christa von Niederhäusen going first. Meaning that Sabina Kosarkova can react to whatever Christa is performing now. Johan Lindström giving her the start sign now. Christa is off, accelerating. This is where it counts. This is the final lap for today. Crossing the start line, it needs to be perfect. Just as perfect as every other run of her so far. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Not sure if that was perfect. She lost a bit of speed in that one turn. What is it? What is it? 13.445. Is this gonna be enough? Is it gonna be enough? I'm not so sure. Sabina Kosarkova is gonna give us the answer in a couple of seconds. The pressure is all on her. She is the last woman on track for today. Full focus for her. All right. Accelerating. Taking a lot of speed onto that first straight. Yes, first, second turn, perfect. Not so sure about this now. Did she lose a bit of momentum there? I don't know. What is it? What is it? Second, Christa von Niederhäusen is taking her third world champions title. Unbelievable. She has been dominating all week long. Wow. The third world champions title for Christa von Niederhäusen from Switzerland. Congratulations. Miss Pump Track, I would say. She took the very, very first world champions title when it was not official yet in 2018 in Springdale, USA. Took the title to Switzerland. Then lost it 1 year later to the USA. Got it back last year in Santiago de Chile. And now defended it, the first actual defender of a world champion's title. And it is her third. Congratulations. Congrats also to Sabina Kosarkova, though. The time in between them at the end wasn't that small. Okay, there we go with the interview. Let's hear it. With Max.
All right, so we're going to have a quick chat with Christa, and we got the cameras over there. Christa, it's been an incredible week. There's been lots happening. This is such a tight track purely because it's so short. Tell us about what's going through your head right now. A three times pump track world champion.
I can't believe it. I'm out of words. It's amazing. And in front of my family, my boyfriend, it's just... Oh, I'm out of words.
Tell us a bit about leading up to this. Obviously, very busy with your studies, studying to be a doctor. You finished that next year. But pump track is something you've really become to love, and you're really just getting quicker and quicker. Do you think that the experience played a major role for you here today?
Yeah, I think so. It gave me the strength to pull it through and to have really good laps in each round. So, yeah, experience helps a lot.
Five world championships, you've won it three times. It doesn't get any better than that.
No, it doesn't. But we said this already last year.
Let's say a quick shout out here to the crowd at Area 47, Utzal, Austria. Haven't they been amazing today?
It was amazing. The show was amazing. The crowd is amazing. So I loved it.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen, your 2023 Velosolutions UCI Pump Track World Champion. For the third time, it's Christa von Niederhäusen of Switzerland.
Impressive performance from Christa there while all the other rounds were decided with only a couple of hundreds or a couple of thousands of seconds, she decided the final with 0.4 of a second, which is the biggest gap basically of the entire week. So she did actually save it for the big finals and let it all out and dominated it massively. Congratulations, definitely the queen of pump track. See her run again, and you could see her there, how high she was riding some of the turns. Basically started them on the red line. What a performance. And now we are going into the men's big final, and there is one guy that is, I'm not sure if he was thinking that he's gonna be in the big final here. Newcomer from Italy, Mattia Kosterman. Getting up on stage for his final run at this year's World Championships.
From the United
States. And another man who's already been in this game before, Alec Bob from the USA. Keeping his warm vest on to the very last second. That's what I would do if I was him. So, Mattia Kosterman is getting ready. He is ready. He's not getting ready. He is ready. Johan Lindström giving him the sign. Course is clear. This is your lap. This is where you can win those rainbow stripes. Little mistake already before the lap even started. Wow, he's taking some risks right there. Very, very uncontrolled run. Really letting it all out. Is it gonna be enough though? Let's see the time. Okay, 12.6 is not the fastest time of the day, but we do not know if Alec Bob will be able to beat it. It was not a clean run, that's for sure. It was definitely full risk. It was all in by Mattia Kosterman right there. All in. I was a bit worried that he was gonna crash. Little mistake even before crossing the start line. Not a perfect run, and Alec Bob probably saw that. So he knows that he might not need to let it all out and just have a safe run. But what does it mean to have a safe run when the differences are only hundreds of a second? So course is clear. Alec Bob, the stage is yours. It's your time to shine. Okay, that is clean. That is so clean so far. Riding the turn very low in comparison to the others. Very low, very low. Not riding the red line. Is that going to be good or bad? What is it going to be? It is first! World champion title goes to the USA. Alec Bob takes the rainbow stripes. But only by one hundredth of a second. One hundredth of a second in between number one and number two. Congratulations, Alec Bob. Wow! Look at it here. 12.67 versus 12.68, 13 milliseconds in between the two. The USA claims the world champion's title back. Alec Bob, not a new man in the game. He's been there for a while. He knows how to deal with pressure. He performed when it counted. Congratulations. And there we have Max with the winner interview.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's drop the music just a little bit and let Alec get his breath back. What a day. It's been absolutely crazy. And he's been wanting this for a long time. He knows he was close last year, second place at the World Championships last year behind Niels Bensink from there. Then today is your moment. You did it for the United States of America. You did it for Alec Bob. Alec Bob, tell us a bit about what is going through your mind right now.
Honestly, I can't even believe it's happened. Winning a world title in BMX, going back to another discipline and trying to win that, it's tough. So luckily I had the help of my parents, my sponsors, Divide, and all my other brands I work with. And honestly, I have a track similar to this. I was able to get in connection with them and solo sessions. So I had a speaker, and just myself, and just going out there and riding. And so to put in that hard work without any of the crowd, which is way tough to do, I'm happy to make it happen.
Do you believe that you've cracked the code on what is needed to continue to get better at this sport? Everyone is just getting so fast. We look at the top times and just how close they are. It's thousands of a second. Do you believe you've slowly put that puzzle together? Is that the reason why you won here today?
Yeah, but honestly, I didn't think I'd be in the position after finishing ninth yesterday, doing my lap at like a 13:10, and realizing I didn't have much left, I felt like. But I think now, understanding the format and just being more comfortable with myself and just being in my own little zone.
A lot of responsibility on your shoulders now to continue to spread the word of pump track. There's a lot of Americans watching right now. A message for the young pump trackers out of the USA?
Do what you enjoy. If pump track's that thing, push for it. Do the training, even if you have to do it solo. Just try and enjoy it as much as you can. Luckily now, there's more series coming up in the States, so I'm happy to push that along and hopefully hit pump track big in the USA.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Let's have one more round of applause for Alec Bob from the United States of America, your 2023 Velosolutions UCI Pump Track World Champion in the Elite Men's category.
Congratulations again. Alec Bob from the USA taking the World Championships title. Together with Christopher Niederhäusern from Switzerland, taking her third title here at the Area 47. And it is time for me to also say thank you to all the partners who made this event happen. Besides Velosolutions, it is the Area 47. It is the Ötztal here in Austria. And it is also vegan chocolate, believe it or not, vegan chocolate. The riders have been eating it all week long, and you see it works. They performed pretty well, and I think they're gonna get a truckload of it as prize money to bring home. So I wonder how we're gonna ship that all over the world. And this is also why what is coming up is usually called the flower ceremony, but we now call it the chocolate ceremony. The vegan chocolate ceremony coming up. On the ring, the top three men and top three women.
In second place, from the Czech Republic, Sabina.
Everyone a bit too excited down there. Alina Beck is not yet There she is in green, Alina Beck from Germany. Bronze medal. This is already the chocolate ceremony.
In first place,
Sabina Kozarkova in second. And we'll go into the fully official ceremonies later on. But here for the live show, you'll only get the chocolate ceremony. The vegan chocolate ceremony. Christa von Niederhäuser taking her third world champions title. Rainbow stripes will be given later at the official prize giving. These are the three fastest women of the 2023 Velosolutions UCI Pump Track World Championships. Congratulate.
Thank you.
So we're looking for the man to show up. Alec Bob, Mattia Kosterman, and Eddie Clerte to grab their chocolate.
Three men in third place. From France, it's Eddie Clerte.
There he is, Eddie Clerte. Not quite sure why he has holes in his jersey there. We didn't see him crash today, did we? There he is. Silver medal winner, Mattia Kosterman. The surprise of the year. I wonder if we're going to give him the Rookie of the Year award. But this is it. This is him. The new world champion, Alec Bob from the USA.
One more time, let's give them a big round of applause, please, ladies and gentlemen. Eddie Clerte, Mattia Kosterman.
Congratulations to you all. What a performance. Alec Bob played it right, performed when he had to.
Because in 5 minutes' time, we will go to the official award ceremony and the handover.
And so it is up to us to already get prepared for next year's World Championships.
Incredible bronze, silver, and gold medals. That'll be coming your way in the next 5 minutes. Please stay around and help us.
Okay, so I'm quickly moving out there to meet Max and see if there's anything else we can tell you. Give me 5 seconds. As you can see, he's still very busy getting organized here. Thank you for your help, man. What would I do without you?
What a day, what a day. I cannot tell you, the racing here has been phenomenal. I've been to all 5 of these, and I mean, these kids just get so fast. I don't know how they do it, but the progression of the sport is just incredible, isn't it?
It is getting pretty serious, eh? I did not know what to say because there was nothing in between the riders. I'm impressed by both of the winners, but mainly with Christa taking such a big gap at the last lap. That's incredible.
Yeah, she did the perfect race. The strategy was there. I mean, she's not a 3-time world champion for nothing, right? Very calculating. She had the perfect day, and what a great ambassador for the sport of pump track. She just really put it all out there. She was clinical, she was totally professional, and she was in a class of her own at the end there. The experience definitely counts.
Definitely, and I think it's up to us now to organize next year's event. It's going to be hard to top this one, but we'll do our best.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, what a crowd here at Area 47. I mean, the crowd here in Austria has been phenomenal. What an amazing 3-4 days we've had here. This indoor arena, I think we need to do another one indoors. I mean, hasn't it been great? The vibe, the atmosphere, absolutely next level.
Okay, so any city out there who wants an indoor pump track, we might come to you with the World Championships. So, you got it, right?
Absolutely. We'll see you all in 2024. We cannot wait to bring you the 6th edition of the Velosolutions UCI Pump Track World Championships. We'll see you then.
There's nothing more to say. He said it all. Thanks for watching. See you soon.